A Total War Saga Troy revolves around dominating personalities that rule from some of the most spectacular cities of the ancient world. Penthesilea is no less in her fame and legend, but in A Total War Saga Troy, she freely roams the map and calls no city or settlement home. A Horde faction functions very differently from other factions. They claim no city is their home, but instead their army is their settlement. Using surplus points more than any other faction to not only grow the Horde, but to construct buildings and recruit certain characters. Upgrading the War Circle and a few other buildings will increase the rate at which the Horde can grow and gain surplus points. You can see that you gain surplus points faster than a non-Horde faction, only taking 20 to get a point. Another way to grow your Horde is to raise and enslave a settlement. This will give you a boost to your growth. Buildings are constructed the same way as any other faction, but as your army is your settlement, you access your buildings by clicking on your army. Here you will see Horde Army and Horde Buildings. Clicking on the Horde Buildings, you will see your available building slots. You have access to military, administration, and temple buildings. Upgrading these will make your unit stronger, will enable you to acquire agents and gain the benefits of worshipping different cults. Bear in mind, you can only construct buildings when you are encamped, but each building only takes one turn to construct. You can see to start with, I have very little resource income. Horde armies survive on raising and raiding, and as such do not receive a supply line penalty when more armies are recruited. When raising a settlement, you can choose one of two options. You can either raise and kill, which will offer less resources but more battle glory, or raise and enslave, offering more resources and Horde growth. Take note of this icon. Different settlements will give you a different bonus for raising them. Some, like this one, will give you resources. These resources scale over time and once acquired will refresh over time. Raising other settlements can give visibility over a region or gain favor with different cults. Of course, there is always trade. Finding a good ally and trading partner to help gain certain resources to give you an edge is always a good idea. There is a focus on ranking up your base level units to be able to upgrade them to be more powerful. Once a unit has reached rank 4, you'll have the option to perform an initiation rite. This will then give you the option to upgrade that unit. Upgrading a unit will depend on what military buildings you have constructed and what level they are at. Here you can see a table of what the higher tier units are. Raising a settlement that would allow you to recruit mythical units will gain you the ability to recruit them from your special recruitment panel indefinitely. It is important to keep moving and to try and keep your units alive. You need to weigh up, is it safe to stop and camp here so I can upgrade this building? You want to give your army time to recover after battles. If you keep having to recruit low-level units, you are going to run into trouble. There are plenty of ways to rank up units outside of battles, using your hero skills or constructing certain military buildings. It's worth noting that you cannot reinforce using another Horde army. Horde armies fight alone. Playing a Horde can be challenging. It's a different way of playing than most other factions, and presents its own problems that you will have to find new solutions to.